Hello and welcome to Petroleum Bites. Today, we'll explore two critical concepts in reservoir engineering, the Inflow Performance Relationship, IPR, and Vertical Lift Performance, VLP. Both are essential for understanding the dynamics of oil and gas production, particularly in well performance evaluation. These two relationships help us model and optimize the extraction process, ensuring that we can produce hydrocarbon efficiently while managing reservoir conditions. So let's get started. So how fluid moves from reservoir up to surface? Imagine we have a completed well on formation with a certain reservoir pressure, and this formation has been subjected to a bottom hole flowing pressure that is lower than reservoir pressure. Then the fluid moves upward to surface toward the lowest flowing pressure. This drawdown caused the movement of reservoir fluid through the rock pore spaces and open perforation to the wellbore. Reduced fluid then moves upward through tubing string to surface at lower pressure, driven by the difference in pressure between bottom hole flowing pressure and the surface flowing pressure. There are many factors that govern the flow rate of produced fluid from reservoir to the surface, like rock properties such as permeability value and net prey thickness, in addition to reservoir fluid properties such as viscosity, formation volume factor, and gas-liquid ratio. The different pressure values and wellbore geometry play a critical role in controlling fluid rates and in determining well capability to produce naturally or to require installation to one of artificial lift methods. Darcy law for radial flow blends all contributing factors in one single equation. It's clear that all equation parameters are constant, except for flow rate and drawdown pressure. This constant value is called productivity index, and it is the amount of flow rate achieved at 1 psi drop in pressure. Productivity index helps in creating and understanding inflow performance relationship curves and well performance. Inflow performance relationship defines the relationship between bottom hole flowing pressure and production rate. IPR curve has two axes. The y-axis shows bottom hole flowing pressure, and the x-axis shows fluid flow rate. The curve has a straight line with constant slope related to well's productivity index. The straight line starts to deviate and bottom hole flowing pressure reaches to a certain value, which we're going to discuss later on in this video. Let's imagine we have a point moves on the curve and find out corresponding flow pressure and flow rate. A flowing rate equal to zero, this means no drawdown exists, and bottom hole flowing pressure is equal to reservoir pressure. When bottom hole flowing pressure value gets lower than the reservoir pressure, wells start to flow to wellbore, with the flowing rate corresponding to the amount of the drawdown and formation productivity index. This behavior goes on until the bottom hole flowing pressure reaches to the bubble point pressure. Bubble point pressure is a pressure value at which the first bubble of gas formed from a liquid. When wells flow at a pressure greater than the bubble point pressure, it flows as a one-phase flow, and it flows as a two-phases flow at any pressure lower than bubble point pressure. When the bottom hole flowing pressure drops to zero, theoretically, the maximum flow rate of the well has been achieved. This point is called as the absolute open flow. There are many ways to create IPR curve. One of these methods is Vogel IPR. When the bottom hole flowing pressure is greater than the bubble point pressure, flow rate is calculated by the knowledge of productivity index and the amount of drawdown. And when the bottom hole flowing pressure falls below bubble point, flow rate is calculated by using Vogel calculation method as shown in the equation below. The Fitkovich IPR model is used to predict the flow rate under various reservoir and bottom hole flowing pressure values. It provides an empirical relationship between the difference of square reservoir pressure and the square bottom hole flowing pressure on y-axis and the production rate on x-axis. Created points form a straight line on log-log scale chart. We can get the flow exponent n and the flow coefficient C that can help in calculating flow rate at different drawdown values. Fitkovich IPR is particularly valuable in assessing the performance of a well during its production phase, and help engineer estimate potential flow rate of new wells or under different reservoir management strategies. IPR curve dynamically changed during the well run life. Every change reflects the current performance of the reservoir rock. For example, flow rate grade may drop as a result of reservoir pressure depletion. This might happen in depletion drive reservoir or in water injection pattern where a lack of injection support occurs. Sometimes the drop in the flow rate is not a result of depletion, but is caused by a deterioration in productivity index. That happens when formation is damaged either naturally or induced from external source. Also, productivity index can be improved by performing any of the stimulation techniques like hydraulic fracturing or matrix stimulation. These techniques help improving flow rate at the same bottom hole flowing pressure. Now let's shift to vertical lift performance or VLP. VLP describes the relationship between the flow rate and the pressure required to lift fluids from the reservoir to the surface, considering the frictional losses in the wellbore. In essence, it models how much pressure is needed to lift fluid through the tubing, factoring in the wellbore condition and the fluid properties as shown in the following equation. The vertical lift performance is influenced by a number of factors. Fluid type as gas, oil, and water all behave differently under flow, affecting the pressure required to lift them. Diameter and the length of the tubing, as well as the restriction in the wellbore, play a significant role in fractional losses. Flow regimes is significantly affected by the gas-liquid ratio of fluid, as flow can be laminar or turbulent, with turbulent flow required higher pressure to maintain the same flow rate. There are many correlations that are used to estimate bottom hole flowing pressure at a certain production rate, fluid property, and gas-liquid ratio. Here is an example of how to use VLP correlation. On x-axis, we select required bottom hole flowing pressure and move downwards vertically until the line intersects with the curve that has gas-liquid ratio value or produced fluid. Then move horizontally to intersect with y-axis. On y-axis, move upward as much as tubing vertical height, then return back again to the same gas-liquid ratio curve. After that, move upward vertically to intersect with the x-axis to get the wellhead flowing pressure. By applying the same concept at different rate, we can get a number of flowing rate at the different bottom hole flowing pressures. The key to well performance lie in the intersection of the IPR and VLP curves. The IPR shows us how much fluid reservoir can deliver, while VLP tells us the pressure required to lift that fluid to the surface. Understanding and optimizing both curves is essential for maximizing well productivity. At the point where the IPR and VLP curves intersect, we have the actual flow rate of the well. If the VLP curve doesn't intersect with the IPR curve, it means the well cannot produce due to lifting constraint. To optimize well performance, we aim to balance between both inflow from the reservoir and the vertical lift constraint by adjusting the following parameters. 1. By pump optimization, selecting the right artificial lift method on VLP and reservoir characteristics. 2. Wellbore maintenance, minimizing frictional losses through proper wellbore design and maintenance. 3. Production rate management, by adjusting the production rate based on the IPR to avoid overproducing and depleting the reservoir prematurely. In conclusion, both the inflow performance relationship and vertical lift performance are critical tools for optimizing well production. While IPR tells us how much fluid the reservoir can provide, the VLP helps us understand the pressure needed to lift that fluid to surface. By analyzing these two curves together, engineers can make informed decisions to maximize efficiency, reduce costs, and ensure long-term well productivity. With that, we concluded our lesson today. I hope you enjoyed the video and it was useful to you. If you have any questions or comments, or you want me to present a certain topic, please write it down in the comments. Or you can send me an email on petroleumbytes@gmail.com. Thanks for watching and see you next time.